Hello audience, my name is Lady, and welcome back to Phoenix Wright Justice Roll. That's a coincidence that we ended up doing the same scene as the last episode. Anyways, we got new information about the acrobat. The cause of the accident 6 months ago was because of Leon. Bit across brother, and yeah. We get to move. And a big top. Press it to Pepper. To see if she reacts.
That's Pepper, isn't it? From the cafeteria?
Huh? It's from the cafeteria?
Is that? I remember seeing it there.
Oh, so this is supposed to come from dear Pepper.
You know, I don't being a big fan of Pepper.
I thought we should shake the pepper on her to see the Oh yeah, we can press the profile to bat. Acrobat. What do you think about this pitch puzzle?
Sorry.
Sorry?
I already gave my hand to another man. I don't think it's really in your dating service.
Huh? I just want to know if you knew the person.
Ah, it's Sakura! Yes, it is true today.
Yes, he is. He just came back from the meeting with him.
I hope his legs get better soon. Sakura's incredible, especially on the trapeze.
The trapeze?
The trapeze is that enormous swingy hanging from the top of his head, right? Yep, that's it. And you want to see him up there again, Akron the Acrobat.
That's strange. Akron doesn't seem to have very nice things to say about Rina. But Rina seems to like Akron just fine. What? Really? Are you just never going to move there from there? Nope. Oh, Mr. Wright, we're back again, is he?
Wait, he did say he'll be back? Wait, where was someone else?
We're back because Akron's hiding with his legs were injured. He was hurt in the accident 6 months ago. It would seem that he knows what we know. Well, but it seems we have got things we want to talk about, so fire away. Okay. Mama Tama! I had to ask you, how were you injured? I'm sorry, I thought we'd talk about this. It was an accident. Leon. 6 months ago you were attacked by a lion. That's when you were injured. That's one luck. I know, I'm on the right track. I just need to keep going.
You're saying that I was attacked by a lion?
That's what I say.
I'm sorry, Mr. Wright, but an acrobat. I'm no animal tamer. If a lion was coming at me, I'd be ready for exit.
I'm not sure if the attack is the best word of using it. You must have battled a lion.
You seem to enjoy telling jokes. Why would you decide to battle a giant?
Because you had a fight with... You had a fight and you had to say someone. Your brother bat. Take that! Diggling. Sorry.
But...
It was a shame what happened to your brother 6 months ago. You tried to save him, didn't you? And that's how you got that terrible injury.
Well, it wasn't told you.
Yes, we learned about Beth from all, but did he mention anything about you in regards of the accident? I suppose it was just a slip of a tongue on this part. That's the way he figured out.
A slip of the tongue? Anyways, there was a criminal thief cut down at the same time. caught them at the same time. That was the where she slipped. That's what we figured out. You two ended up wrapped on the same accident together, like always.
I see.
But an accident is an accident. It wasn't anyone's fault. I still haven't broken across the Cyclock. He must have an incredible deep and seated secret. It wasn't anyone's fault. What do you care to explain? Akro, I know you are still hiding something from me. Maybe something you don't seem to like much is recently you and Regina. Regina. You always seem to come and collect it until you start talking about her. Saying things like she's cruel. Well, no, Mr. Tony, I've got quite a set of eagle eyes. You know, her tiger tried to attack me. Regina tried to attack you? Twice. He wasn't serious, I'm sure. You're not trying to insinuate that I believe she spurred on the Leo to attack Matt, do you? Leo was never told to come out to attack people. Regina isn't capable of doing anything like that. Besides, Regina had no reason to want to hurt my little brother. Regina and Matt was a sugar prince back then. But you still hate Regina! I got the proof of it!
What? What are you talking about?
Duh! Maybe I'd over... Maybe I overdid it again. But if you can handle something to Akro, maybe it will. Here's the proof that you had to...
Where did you get it?
Regina posted it on the bulletin board in the cafeteria. Before that, it was on her pocket.
I guess I noticed it wasn't around breakfast time. It was take Akro's breakfast in the morning.
You wrote this and then you put it in the pocket. That's right, isn't it?
That's right. Well, that is right.
Whew. Full bargain!
My legs were injured by Leon. 6 months ago, my younger brother Matt had a dare with Regina.
A dare?
An absurd dare. If you could put my head inside of Leon's mouth like you do, you had to go to the movies with me on a date.
That's insane! Did you know how dangerous that is?
Well, all thought he was doing was being stupid too, but that lie was very old to begin with. And age brought with the contest experience in doing that very trick. Unfortunately, this particular time, I guess Leo wasn't ready or willing.
That's when the accident happened.
He just wanted to take her out to the movies.
Poor Matt.
When Leo jumped down, I jumped towards him. Then Leo attacked me, and that's how I ended up.
What about that?
He's still in a coma. I went to the hospital yesterday to visit him.
I see.
I stayed waiting for him to open his eyes again. And that's the reason why I keep going.
Better Regina. They were such a great friends.
Oh yeah, I wanted you to take a look at this.
What is it?
This is a scarf my brother was wearing when Leon attacked him.
Gross, it's covered in blood!
This scarf. Was a present for Regina to my brother on the day of the accident. When he did it, he looked like he was smiling.
He?
Leon, obviously.
What?
When he bit down on Matt's head, the expression on Leon's face looked like a grin.
Nick!
I know, both said the same thing.
What do you think it will be?
I will be taking a scarf, you don't mind.
Vakarma! Everyone here, David Drake, so hand over the scarf. But the scarf is always the trial. That is for me to decide. I think we should begin our preparation now, Akro.
Preparations?
I will serve the summons of Akro to appear in court tomorrow as a witness. Akro, we will talk about it at the prosecutor's office. Akro, a witness? Come, Akro, let's go to the office.
Yes, ma'am.
Now what do we do, Nick? How are we going to handle tomorrow?
Don't worry about it, we'll figure something out.
Look at you, full of confidence. You must have found something you can use.
It's all beginning to come together now. To be continued. Well, accuracy is a witness.
Oh. Where's the start menu? Wait, let the test. Start menu. That was a pause. Okay, I don't know what. December lobby. What?
Good morning, Max!
Oh yeah, good morning, sweeties. You don't seem like you're so sparkling itself today. I always like this before I go in front of an audience. I broke it up to me. Regina, you're inside the circus for the first time in your life!
Don't get nervous, Maxie. Here, have a glass of milk. Regina!
Oh, fabulous, my princess! You came to watch my performance today.
Of course I did. Mom told me I should come and watch it.
Mom said it.
So what kind of a person were you meeting today? Let me guess, you were from your dad?
I'm not that kind of a show. It's not that kind of a show, it's not right, my sweeties.
Huh?
I think my sweetie pie princess doesn't... Yeah, she doesn't seem to realize what's going on, or even where she is.
Well, Max, it looks like it's about to raise the curtain. I will see you later. Today, I'm just a member of the audience.
Fabulous, enjoy yourself out there.
Good luck, Max. You're the best. She's different, don't you think?
Top of the morning to y'all! Everyone get ready to get stuck in the legal limbo! How low can you go? How low can you go? How low can you go? Whoa! Top of the morning to you, give it all! Top of the morning to you, Larry! top of the morning? Does it get attacking and they start with energy in the morning? The early bird gets the worm, but then again, worms lack higher brain functions. Here, Max, I brought you a present. Have some milk. Oh my, thank you! So, how are you today, Max? Right. Well, I got the feeling today I'm going to face off against the green criminal. You will not grow.
Huh? You think you did it?
Be careful. He's used to putting his life on the line, literally. 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 He got guts to spare. It's all I got to worry about is how thin the tightrope is. I've used it already. It just means that I won't be able to freeze him like without a witness. What are you going to do then, Nick? I guess today we have to do without our usual psychology warfare. Today we rely on evidence. It's the only way we get past accurate truth.
You're right, but it's going to be tough.
Anyways, I want you to make sure that Regina sees it all today. It's important. Then she will finally have to deal with the reality of what happened to her father.
You want us to make sure Regina watches?
Yes, that's why I brought her to court today. What's that supposed to mean? She needs to know when people die, they don't just become stars. I may be old-fashioned clown, but I don't believe in people becoming stars.
Thank you for the ruined hopes for Regina.
The court is now in session in trial of Maximilian Galactica.
The prosecution is ready, Your Honor.
The defense is ready, Your Honor.
Very well, Miss Montgomery, you may proceed with your case.
The prosecution would like to clarify its previous theory of the events.
What's the meaning of this?
We have discovered a new witness, or shall I say, a new eyewitness. What that saw Maximilian Galactica fly off the scene of the crime.
Order! Order! I had a feeling something like this would come up.
due to this revision, we are prepared, now prepared to explain how the defendant flew that night. An explanation the prosecution will present if the need to so arises. In fact, my detective stayed up all night ready to mock up of the scene, on my orders.
Poor Gumshoe. Very well, please call your witness to stand. Time to get to work, or shall I say, time to walk the court of tightrope. Oh.
Name and occupation.
Ken Diggling. Ken Diggling, but everyone calls me Duck Rope. I'm a brother son of and a pair of big suckers.
Where were you at the night of the crime?
I was in my room that night. If you look at the map, you will see...
If you look at the map, you will see the witness of the room is near the crime scene.
My room is on the third floor. The crime scene is below my window.
The night of the crime, witness saw something quite shocking. Will you tell us what you witnessed?
Okay. I was up for 10 PM, I was resting my bed. Around the time I heard a large thump noise from the outside window. Then a few moments later I saw someone flying right by my window. It was Max Galactica. I also saw him from behind, that's who it looked like. To be honest, when I saw that I thought it was dreaming.
So the witness testimony matched up exactly what the clown said. Is that the case? Very little the prosecutor did add. Honestly, he explained how the defendant's speech appeared in this kind of light. That night.
Before we get that far, I'd like to cross-examine the witness.
A foolish choice by a foolish fool who wishes to fool. So wishes to feel the foolish sadness of a sad fool. A man must know the proper timing of things when he feels right. Just like your old friend, Miles Edgeworth, did.
Mr. Wright, do you have a problem with the witness testimony? In the words of Miss Gomer, may I court yesterday's proceedings? There's no way that actually happened.
Very well, you may proceed with your cross-examination.
Your room is on the third floor, right?
Yes.
Yes. Are you still able to rest in the bed?
That is correct.
Were you still able to hear a sound from the side?
I was indeed.
Sorry.
I was indeed.
Pressing aqua doesn't seem to get results. Maybe it's something must continue with what you said. Oh my god, already?
There's a huge contradiction with the testimony that was given.
If there's a contradiction, then prove it with the evidence.
Oh, shoot.
Oh, she's right. Let's see some evidence. Do you have any evidence supporting them before contradiction?
What's the matter, Mr. Wright? Nothing, Your Honor. It's like a final contradiction. I should tread it right lightly.
What is he thinking?
Are you sure it wasn't a human being? It could have been a mannequin or perhaps a large action figure.
Well, certainly there's a possibility of a mannequin of action figure is possible.
You have no idea the best words with Missy Fields, right? Testify to the truth, and only the truth, just as we were there with you that night.
I believe it was a human.
Damn it, illustrated his testimony. I wonder if I can state what he used with the facts.
What's the matter?
The light in your room was turned off, right?
That's true, I was going to bed after all.
So with the lights off, you were still able to clearly see a human fly by your window?
The safety lights lit things up enough for me to see. But honestly, there was only enough light for me to see the silhouette outside my window. It was the person's back, so I could see the white roses on the front.
Did you see any other symbols?
Well, we got serious. A curious on the steel cut, as well as the cloak wrapped around his body. I'm convinced that the person I saw was Max Galactica. The more impressive, the less result I seem to get. But maybe there was something fishy with this.
What's wrong?
Nothing, other.
Oh my god, Mr. Wright, you see the...
When did you start thinking that when you saw was not me? That's not important.
I believe that the prosecutor had done a bit of maintenance on the witness's memory.
We'll just make sure less as to witness.
Oh! Objection! Sustain! Don't sustain that! Akron must be lying about things, huh?
Of course he is. Don't the sheriff will expose his lies to the court.
But put the pedal on the pedal neck.
You said that we were resting in bed?
I would assume that you turned the lights off, incorrect?
That's right. That's correct. There was safety lights on the outside of the rotting house. It's so bright, sometimes it makes it hard to sleep.
If that's the case, would you pick up the tail across the curtains?
Where did the bird come from, anyway?
I never really thought of that. I guess I missed some of the bites of curtains.
Sometimes I do make myself useful in these chambers. Oh! Then we didn't proceed with this testimony.
Wait a minute.
Oh my god, I totally forgot I had this picture of the bust.
Then I have the evidence then.
If there's a contradiction, then prove it with your evidence.
Oh, she's right. Let's see some evidence. Do you have any evidence to support your claim? Oops.
Nope.
What in the world is this?
Oh! You just don't get it, do you, Mr. Fist, right?
What do I get?
You're not going to be able to go through with this pollution bluff routine. Your client looks to be ready to take off and once again. Stretch over a guilty verdict.
You were bluffing? I will not forgive any more mockers made of this court.
Whoops. Witness, would you mind repeating your testimony?
With pressure.
Sorry guys, I have to stop here a little bit. Okay!
I found out. But I don't remember to press. Yep. No, well, I totally forgot about the hat. It was left behind the crime scene. You claim to have seen exact same thing as Mo saw that night. Do you stand by that?
What do you mean?
The sea cat.
What about the sea cat? I saw it on Max's head on them as it flew by the window.
Well, you should have tried looking down out of your window that night.
That would be quite difficult in the state I'm in. Just looking outside of the window was not tough enough to shine for me.
That's a shame, because you would have noticed the secret from the crime scene.
That's the ringmaster's hat, right?
Afraid not. No matter how you look at it, this is the Max Sin Cat.
Where are you going with this, Mr. Wright? Are you saying that Max has two Sin Cats?
No, this is a handmade, one of the kind of made only from Max Wing Galactica. Which means, Acro, don't you be figured on the sand?
Order!
Like always, someone has to open their mouth before thinking.
Are you okay, Nick?
Well, I opened my mouth, big mouth, and now we have to back it up.
Oh, but I'm right. What would cause this witness to come and sweep?
Your Honor, on this occasion the defense accuses Akro himself.
On this occasion?
Accuses Akro? What are you accusing him for?
Obviously we accuse him for the murder of Mr. Rosemary.
Mr. Wright, are you serious?
Deadly serious, Your Honor.
I think your tips on the circus have served you well. You seem to remember how to try and grab an audience and hearts and minds. Your Honor, don't allow yourself to be swayed by a theatric. Try to move the crowd with the smoke and the mirrors and the oldest bluff in the book.
Really?
If you don't believe me, just look at the witness. He's calm enough for it to be... He's calm enough for it to almost be scary.
The hummingbird is poking my forehead!
Ow! Stop that stupid bird! He's staying right in the calm and collected. Oh, stop it already!
Mr. Dingling!
Oof! Do you have any response to the first question? A cushion? I don't really need to say anything, do I?
What do you mean?
Everyone take a good look at me. I can't even stand up by myself, let alone leave the Dutch house.
That's true.
I understand that Mr. Wright is trying to help his client. But to do this by accusing me of a murder of all things?
See? Even a silver of common sense makes it clear that a question is ludish.
She's
right. I need to pick up a disabled in your heart, cruel man. Heart is cruel man.
Phoenix and poopy head!
See that?
See that, Mr. Phoenix Wright? If you try to drum up support for the peanut gallery, then how do you do it? That's how you do it. I think that's enough for this little game. I got a doctor's note to confirm that the person able to stand under his own power. Maybe the defense is planning on making a claim to a counter resistance as well. I can hear the defense now. Agra has had an accomplice.
What do you say about this, Mr. Wright? Did I have an accomplice?
Yes. Statue!
Shh.
Is it possible for a grackle to be murdered in this case? If that's the case, then it's natural for them to proceed if possible.
Oh, you don't say.
Not good, not good. This is going to end well.
Don't tell me you think you're going to get off easy.
What?
You must be not to hear that sound just now. It wasn't clear enough. The sound of you falling in your own trap to be hard. Can be hard to notice sometimes.
Miss Wright, you see that you won't be able to survive, you will make it on occasions. If I continue not having a complex, things are not good for you.
I understand your order.
Very well, let's continue. Who patients would happen to be awkward or complex? you don't say!
Uh-oh, this suddenly looks very, very bad.
Don't tell me you think you're gonna get off that easy.
What?
Oh, did you hear that?
What?
The sound of you getting caught in your own trap. What a splendid accomplice. I'm sure this location is built on a solid foundation.
Foundation? Yes, Mr. Wright. Do you have any proof of that this person?
The bust?
What? Is it the right sensor?
Mr. Wright.
Yes, Your Honor? This piece of evidence is like it is in processing power.
Do you really miss that sound? Did you miss it, Mr. Wright? You know, the sound of you receiving a patent.
Say about this, Mr. Wright. Did you have an accomplice?
No, we didn't.
No, that name must be when we get to hear the name of the Mr. Accomplice.
Not this time, Miss Von Karma.
What?
You're not going to sucker me into this one.
What are you babbling about, Mr. Wright? Right.
There's no accomplice. How could I plan to commit the murder itself? All by itself.
Order! What are you getting at?
Why do you keep them on their toes, Nick?
Now I'm going to have to prove how it all fits together. I will show how Acker murdered Bristleberry.
Can you do that, Nick? Can you really do that?
I know what I can do. I can stop now. If I stop now attacking, I'm doomed.
Alright, let's do it! Mr. Finn is right. If this witness is the killer, then his white witness account is all lies, right?
Mr. Wright, I'd like to clear something up for me. When the crime was committed, exactly where was Mr. Diggly?
Here?
He was obviously here the entire time. That's Akra's room? Pretty simple, eh? Akra wasn't able to leave the lodging house by himself. There's only one answer to that. Akura can't leave his room. Didn't leave his room to kill the ringmaster.
What are you nuts?
What say you, Mr. Dingling? What say you, Mr. Dingling? What do you have to say, Mr. Dingling?
Is it a theory?
That's it.
Consider that what you proposed is impossible. Yes, that's it. Yes, that's it.
Mr. Wright?
Yes, Your Honor.
As the witness has stated, your assertion is impossible. As he is in the wheelchair, there's no way he could go to the scene or be the killer.
You got a point.
You say they have forgotten once again, Mr. Vincent Wright, and the defendant was clearly spotted at the scene of the crime.
That's true!
Mom said that you saw Max, didn't he?
Got adopted by aliens. But why are this still impossible for humans to fly?
Do you mind if I ask a question, Mr. Wright?
What is it?
I understand some of the logic. However, how do you think that I killed him? If I didn't have... If I can't leave a room, obviously could he wear Max's costume? How did he do it?
That's the next course of this buffet. Be careful, Nick. If he must appear.
She's right, it can disappear. I gotta give someone serious stuff. I should have killed the ringmaster. And he killed the ringmaster when he was in his room. No doubt about it.
Time to enlighten us to how Mr. Dingley committed the murder crime.
I got the presence of evidence.
So what did Mr. use to commit the murder crime?
What's that? A picture? It is indeed. The problem is, with the item that showed in the picture.
The bust?
It's quite a large bust, because it is life-sized, it is also very, very heavy.
Heavy?
Heavy enough to guarantee a certain death. Especially if it was dropped from the third story window. See? This is how Walker was able to kill the Ringmaster. With the force of gravity and Maximilian Galactus' ample bust. With that bust!
Order, order! So you're saying the bust fell into the Ringmaster?
I'd rather see him cry. But even if he was stuck in his wheelchair, it would be incredibly easy to commit.
How could you possibly wheel a wheelchair? Wheel a wheelchair with something so heavy? Is it possible?
Well, Agro's an acrobat. He should have more than enough upper body strength to carry something like the bust.
Mr. Dingling, how do you respond to these charges?
Charges? Well,
Akko's at lower force.
He should be. He knows that getting close to the truth. Well, Akko, you can't run away from things.
Ah! Any watch what to say if I were you, Mr. Vincent Wright?
What?
Your Honor, the physical health of the witness is material of this case. And I might have got the proper testimony from the witness himself.
Testimony, say? But karma! She's just using this testimony as a rose to stand for time.
There's obviously no need for such testimony.
The defense has its version of the burden, the prosecutor has the right to respond.
The defense objection is overruled. Why can't I see things the way... My way once in a while.
Mr. Dingling, I'm sorry, but we need to testify about your physical condition. If you have any news about your ability to testify, we can request an expert testimony.
The witness will have no promise, however. Let's always be respectful to him.
Thank you.
That woman will sink to any law to win the case.
Okay, guys, I have to end this episode. We got... the real murderer, I think. Yeah, he must be the real murderer. So, anyways, thank you for watching. Leave a like, comment, subscribe if you liked it, and I hope to see you in the next video. Bye bye.